Well, last year, in October, thousands of youths in Port Harcourt defied a ban by the River State Government on all public processions as the wave of protests against police brutality swept across the country. For more than a week, different groups took to the streets to mount pressure on the government to take action on police reforms. One year after, residents are still skeptical about the amount of progress made to meet their demands. Our correspondent, Uche Okoro, reports.
On the 12th of October 2020, the River State government announced a controversial ban on all protests across the state as large crowds continued to mobilize against police brutality in other parts of the country. But determined to add their voices to an agitation that was fast gaining global attention, protesters gathered in Port Harcourt and marched to the state government house the next day. On the 16th of October, youths converged on Waterlines Junction along the Port Harcourt Abar Expressway for a candlelight procession in honor of victims of police brutality. For the next few days, different groups took turns embarking on solidarity protests, calling for an end to high-handedness and extrajudicial killings allegedly suffered at the hands of police officers.
Women are grossly affected by this. They have become an endangered species. They have become the most vulnerable because the people that have been profiled and killed are their sons and their husbands and the hope of every home.
Commercial activities almost ground to a halt as protesting youths consistently occupied major parts of Port Harcourt metropolis. The NSAS protests in River State were peaceful until hoodlums hijacked it and attacked four police stations in three local government areas. These deadly clashes led to the death of three police officers. An unspecified number of arms and ammunition were stolen, while many operational and private vehicles were destroyed. The violent turn of events forced the state government to impose a 24-hour curfew on Oibo and other affected areas. One year after, what lessons have been learned? How far has the state risen above the protests, violence, destruction of property, and loss of lives?
You see, have cases where residents are still intimidated, even after the NSAS campaign. But that campaign has been able to mitigate that level, the high rates at which the security agencies victimized residents of this state.
Police brutality is still an issue in Nigeria today. It still needs to be dealt with, but I think some successes have been recorded. SARS was ended, but police brutality still continues, and it's an ongoing journey, it's an ongoing struggle that will need to continue beyond just this previous NSAS protest.
Some victims of police brutality have lamented the failure of relevant authorities to implement the recommendations of the judicial panel of inquiry set up by the state government. Doing this, they say, remains critical to the national healing process. Uche Okoro, TVC News, Port Harcourt.